It's... Where is he? There he is. Come on.
I am the light of the world. He who follows me will not walk in darkness, but have the light of life. Jesus said, I am the light and the omega. The beginning and the end, the one who was, and who is.
What is over there?
Have you forsaken your sin? Are you living a life obedient to God? If not, just because all your friends are doing evil, doesn't mean it's wrong. Just because it feels good, doesn't make it right. Just because it sounds good, doesn't make it true. There is no truth or mercy or knowledge of God in the land by lying and swearing and killing and committing adultery. Repent! The kingdom of heaven is at hand.
And then
the
Lord
Jesus Christ is
going
to return again to cause the heaven to
fall
back and forth. The sun is going to be the sun and the moon and the stars. And on the earth, it is such a nation with complexity. The sea and the waves roaring, the hearts burying from fear, but the expectation of those things are happening on the earth. Take heed to yourself, lest you be deceived, and your hearts be weighed down, cockiness, carousing,
and the cares of this world.
And
in the
days of Noah, so also the coming of the Son of Man be. As in the days before the flood, they were eating and drinking,
sharing
and going to marriage, until the day that Noah entered the ark, and the flood came and destroyed them all.
What? How long have you been recording?
The wrath is coming. The same
God, I'm
heaven
is
the same
earth
that can now preserve, and all the people are reserved with fire.
Keep going then.
Righteous. If we sin willfully, as receiving the knowledge of truth, there no longer remains a sacrifice of sin, but fearful expectation of judgment and fiery indignation, which will devour the adversaries. God is not begging for you to accept Him. He lets you breathe again today. He gave you a pass today, and walk by Him. He commands you to repent.
Honestly, I think you
surrender all you are.
Without a permit, he's not on campus, that's why.
Do not make any graven image of my likeness, the things in heaven above, on the earth beneath, on the waters under the earth, for I am the Lord your God, the jealous God, visiting the iniquity of the fathers, the third and fourth generation of those who hate me. God is jealous for His glory.
Okay, I'll help you.
Turn from your idols to God. Serve the living and true God today. Amend your way to praise and love. Put that bird in the cage. Get right with the Lord Jesus Christ today. Turn from your evil ways today. Turn your sexual perversion. Turn your homosexuality. Turn from your drunkenness, your revelries, your weak, your marijuana smoking. Turn your perverted ways. That an abomination before God was to perish and God destroy it. God is righteous. The Lord God Almighty will judge the world in righteousness. The Lord Almighty says, I will punish the world for its evil and the wicked for their iniquity. I will halt the arrogance of the proud. I will lay low the hardness of the poor. The day of the Lord comes, full with both wrath and judgment, to make the land desolate, and He will destroy his sinners from it. The great day of the Lord is near. It is near, and it hastens quickly. The noise of the day of the Lord is bitter. All the mighty men shall cry out. That day is a day of wrath, a day of trouble and distress, a day of devastation and desolation, a day of darkness and gloominess, a day of clouds and thick darkness, a day of trumpets.
Alive!
I will bring this just upon the earth, and they shall walk right by men, because they sinned against the Lord, for blood shall be poured out like dust.
I had a dream!
I dreamed that dream!
For the day of the Lord's wrath, and the whole land shall be devoured by the fire of His jealousy. God is jealous, and the Lord avenges. The Lord avenges and is furious. He will take vengeance on His adversaries. The adversaries of God and the enemies of God are all those right now estranged, separated from Christ. Jesus came and fulfilled the law. He kept the commandments of God that you could not keep. In perfect obedience and death, He died on the cross and shed His blood for the remission of sins. On the third day, the Lord Jesus Christ rose again from the dead. The
believe in Christ and trust in Him as your Savior. If you accept the Lord Jesus Christ,
I'm just take the baby and come
it. We will be destroyed. We will be dead.
Come here, kiss me.
One more person is dead in this fight. 100 feet away from eternal death of the soul and body in the lake of fire. The
power the record, holy
of believers, the abominable, the murderers, the sexually unknown, the drunkards, drug addicts, sorcerers, and all liars. I have their blood in the lake which burns in fire and brimstone. This is the second death. And anyone not found written in the book of life was cast into the lake of fire. Are you ready with God?
No.
No. No.
Maybe?
No one can plead the case. They can't hire an attorney. Every thought, every word, every deed, you're committed. You can account for innocent judgments. You don't want to come into church. You want to be saved from that judgment. You can have a living relationship with Jesus Christ.
Are you
Christ.
Kidding me?
Seek the Lord while He may be found. Call the Son of Christ here. Let the wicked forsake His ways. And let the righteous man
going to hell now. Yep. Basically. Oh, I hope you're aware of that.
I got like 5
of
at home.
Really? Oh, wow. There you go. Do you want your chance back?
Surrender your shit goodness.
Yes, the police are here. I want to see this.
Yeah, the police are here. Come on. Here you go.
Bad boys, bad boys.
Oh, there's another lady.
Jesus had people who were prostitutes, they followed Christ. Anybody. Sin is here anyway.
There's no partiality with sin in God's eye. Even someone.
So why would He create somebody that even He thinks that He would?
Okay.
People can't choose that.
There's no difference.
Who was actually that killed during the
all of a sudden.
Excuse me, you're not answering my question. You're not answering. Well, then you have to have things to back that up. That's something that's just not a verse. Not in the verse of the Old Testament. He also said you can't have meat.
A woman should not lie with another woman. It is a sin.
God says you can't. A man can't lie with a woman before premarriage, and anyone does it anyway.
We can't put you away, man. Let's just tell him.
Satan loves you.
Yeah!
Don't come with your heart of God. The wrath of God is coming. The nations of the world. The wrath of God is coming. The judgment of God is upon America as a nation. You can be redeemed from your condition by the blood of Christ. God gives you a new heart.
What a mess.
You no longer practice sin. The evidence that somebody has believed in Jesus Christ will result in the manifestation of
obedience,
the love of God. And that's what the Bible teaches.
Oh my God.
So the God in the Bible is the one you're going to answer to. Not the God you make up in your own mind. When most of us today create our own image of God,
come on.
Like Santa Claus, that just lets you do whatever you want because He loves you and He's going to forgive you. That's not the God of the Bible. That God Lucifer is Satan deceiving you and transforming himself into an angel of light. Jesus Christ, the light, is God. God is light, and in Him there is no darkness at all. He who says, I know God, I know Him, and does not keep His commandments, is a liar. And the truth is not in Him. The Bible says, let him not be without hypocrisy, of war, not of steel, and greed, not of sin. God's love is not hypocrisy. God's love is to be a leader. The command is
like a nice
to the wrong to the better. And no man, God is kind to the unthankful evil. Do you despise the riches of his goodness, forbearance, and long-suffering towards us, not knowing that the goodness of God needs repentance? The Bible says, because of your hardness and impending hearts, you are treasuring up for yourselves wrath in the day of wrath and revelation of the righteous judgment of God, who will limit each person according to their deeds. You don't want to treasure up for yourselves wrath.
Do it.
The wrath of God abides upon the sinner. That's the anger of the Lord turned towards the criminal. We are all criminals in the sight of the Holy God because of sin until you're born again. When you're born again, God gives you a new heart. He clothes you in the righteousness of Jesus Christ and takes away your sins and sees you as the Son of God. That's what God says. When the fullness of the time had come, God sent forth his Son, born of a woman, born in the law, that he might redeem us, redeem those who are under the law, that they may receive the adoption of sons. So you can be adopted into the family of God, becoming a child of God through the Lord Jesus Christ. Because he never sinned, because he obeyed God, submitting to the lordship of God the Father as a man. He humbled himself, and became obedient to the point of death, even the death of the cross. Therefore, God has also highly exalted him, and has given him the name that is above every name.
Do it.
In the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow. Of those in heaven, and of those on earth, and of those under the earth. And every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord to the glory of God the Father. Bless in the pure in heart, for they shall see God. Everyone who has his hope in Jesus Christ purifies himself just as he is pure. Jesus came to redeem us from every lawless deed. He came to redeem the children from every lawless deed and to purify himself, his own special people, selfish people of heart. God makes his children pure. So if you love Jesus and you trust in Jesus, you're going to be living a life of purity. You're going to be living a life of virtue. You're going to be living a life of righteousness. You're going to be living a life of holiness. Are you living that way? Are you still doing drugs? Are you still fornicating? Are you still listening to filthy music? Do you still love Kanye West and Lady Gaga and all the filthy, wicked musicians of the world and celebrities that God hates? All the wickedness that God hates, that God holds, that's made by Lucifer, that poison your ears, the filthy drugs, the filthy sexual perversion, all the ways of God that the nations of the world prefer to hurt. All the ways of God that America is promoting. The curse of Almighty God is going to befall this nation because of harlotry, spiritual fornication with false gods, deserting God for harlotry, the one true God made you, the one true God that you served and gave you everything you have, and God commands you to return to him. Surrender to him, amend your evil ways, and your deeds today. Now is the acceptable time. Now is the day of salvation. God is commanding repentance is a godly sorrow for the crimes you committed against God, so that you no longer continue to live a life of unrighteousness, lawlessness. The Bible says in the last days, because lawlessness will abound, the love of many will grow cold. You see, love grows cold. It's not love, it's lust. It's not godly pure love that God gives you when you come to him. Your pure love is God. God's love is unconditional in Christ. That you cannot be separated from when Jesus dwells inside of you by his Spirit. If anyone does not have the Spirit of Christ, he or she is not his. When the Holy Spirit lives inside of you, you live a holy life. The Holy Spirit is holy. God makes his people pure and righteous. They don't just make excuses of why they could sin and live in disobedience because they're under grace. Like most churchgoers today in America. Like most of the pastors don't preach the gospel to you. They don't tell you these things in buildings like Sunday and most places in America. You gotta give this back to high school. It's not about your youth group. It's not about your own works. You can't get to God by anything you do. Jesus did it all on the cross, becoming a curse for us. When God destroyed his son on the cross,
Jesus bore the curse and the guilt of his people. God cursed his son on the cross. He was innocent. He didn't commit any crime. There was no deceit found in his mouth. He was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement for our peace was upon him. And by his stripes were healed. So now, by receiving Jesus Christ, as many as receive Jesus, to them he gave the right to become children of God. For those who believe in his name, for those who know of God, those who know of Christ, those who know of man, son of God. Turn to the Lord Jesus Christ with all of your heart today. Turn from your evil ways today. Turn from wickedness. Turn from unrighteousness and surrender to Jesus Christ and to give you a new heart. The power of the Holy Spirit to obey his laws and to do what he says. And when you do sin, you will not continue to remain in sin because you love God so much, you won't want to hurt him anymore. You won't be able to continue to do evil anymore habitually because God has changed the nature. Just like a butterfly. When a caterpillar goes into the cocoon, he becomes like a butterfly. If anyone is in Christ, he or she is a new creation. Old things have passed away. Behold, all things have become new. The time is fulfilled. The kingdom of heaven has come here. Repent and believe in the gospel. God bless you. Father God, we thank you for the word. That's right. That's why we ask the Lord. I pray that every student here will the word of God. Lord, you grant those repentance and call those out of darkness in your marvelous light that you've ordained in Christ. Lord God, I pray that you open blind eyes, unstop the deaf ears, bind the works of the devil. I pray that you would, Lord God, not that the Lord, whoever wants to not to see the way, but be souls. Thank you for the mighty work and your mighty holy word that will not return evil. We bless your holy name. As you said that everything that has breath, praise the Lord, and all flesh shall bless your holy name forever and ever. Thank you, Lord God, for the blood of your cross. Thank you, Lord God, for sending the Lord Jesus to do what he could not do. Thank you, Father God, for your indescribable gift. Oh, Lord God, may those who heard your voice plant and water their seed, Lord God. Give the increase according to your will. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Do you have a question? Yes, I do. Woo! I'm sorry.
What do you think about homosexuals?
I just...
What do you think towards it?
Well, same thing I think about heterosexuals.
My church
the same thing I think about heterosexuals and homosexuals and every other perverse thing. You don't. You can love somebody without having sex with them. Sexual perversion and cheating on God with another man or woman is evil. Okay, when Jesus becomes your man and he lives inside of you, you don't commit adultery with him. You obey him. You love him. And even though you might be prone and tempted to and attract another man or woman, you don't go have sex with them outside of a marriage covenant. Now, God made marriage for man and woman. Because if your daddy had another daddy, you would never be born. And if your mommy had another mom, you would never been born. So God's ways are true and right
is
and
love
good.
Is love a sin? Is love a sin?
God's no, ways are sin. Righteous and good. So he made love marriage good. Sin. And sexual relations in the context of marriage but between then, a man and woman to reproduce.
Because next time, can you do this downtown?
Because of the... Because of the fall of man, I understand. But your daughter needs to get right with God, and so you, man, you need to come to
your sin. Do not judge me, and I will not judge you.
Well,
so you can
I will judge no, with righteous judge. Judgment and tell you that if you're not right with God, you're going to be, you're under the wrath of God. And by your response,
also
I know you're not
people
right
people of God.
Okay, so no, the point is,
she wants you to go.
There is no peace in the world. And so if you love God, you would say thank you, Jesus. You would say thank you, Jesus. But because you don't love God and you love yourself and you love your own work. It's true. Because if you love God, you would rejoice in the gospel.
My daughter's trying to do homework.
These kids need Christ. And let me tell you something.
Yeah, you go, girl.
She
has
a testimony.
So if a man and a man get married, what would you think of that? What if they adopted a child and his mother abandoned them?
God hates
sin. God doesn't hate anymore.
God hates wickedness. He doesn't hate righteousness.
And what's so wicked about two men loving each other, two women loving each other?
Well, what's wicked about that is that... I love my brothers and sisters in Christ and even my enemies, men and women, but I don't have sex with them. I don't commit sodomy with them.
People
I don't do evil things.
People
I don't
have sex
I don't,
in marriage.
I don't exchange chemicals with them and do evil things with
sex.
Them. God hates sexual perversion.
Me?
Okay? And so God's a holy God. It's who he is.
Is that what
and so
saying?
Some
love's not a sin.
Love is holy. Love it. God's love is pure and righteous.
So, can if, we just what is that? So if two men love each other, that's holy in and of itself.
Well, it has to. Yeah, and we need to love. Love has got to be God's love.
Just like sit down and have some coffee and just like not be angry about this.
Nobody's angry.
We could just have a lovely coffee.
Nobody's angry at all, but God is angry at the wicked every day. Okay, so you're gonna turn from your evil ways and turn to Jesus, the God of the Bible, is the one true God. We know who He is, because we don't know Him. He made you. It's His ways that are right. Our ways are wrong.
We're wrong with God. Man has with the women. It also says,
do you know the Lord?
Context,
the important thing is you know Jesus.
It says before me.
I do know Jesus. I was baptized. But
that doesn't
I'm
mean you know
saved.
Jesus.
I do know Jesus.
Being baptized does not mean you know Jesus.
I know.
Knowing Jesus when you're born again. Knowing Jesus is when you're born again of the Holy Spirit.
That's good. You seem familiar.
As a result of being saved, if you got baptized,
go for it if you want.
Inwardly. If you get baptized in a pretense of not knowing Christ and doing it for a religious ritual, that cannot make you right with God. There's no right. Your righteousness. Your righteousness is as filthy rags to God. God's righteousness is keeping the righteous requirements of His law in perfect obedience to death.
Why can't we just settle this at Starbucks? We are messing up a girl's education. We couldn't just settle this at Starbucks.
Does that mean nobody's going to go to heaven?
Like, why is that?
Well, we all belong to hell until you're born again. You belong
exactly.
to hell.
You
but someone doesn't need to go to hell?
Until you're born again. Our
yeah.
Father is
Lucifer. Woo!
Satan. Woo! We are children of wrath until you're born again.
Our Father is That's not Satan.
Until you're born again.
Our Father is definitely God.
We are born in
No, he's not. Your Father's Satan because of the curse until a person.
I believe in science.
Was it Adam and Eve?
Science.
The son and daughter.
God made Adam and Eve.
So naturally,
but they also sinned. But you know what? God still had grace on them.
Come if you want.
God's forgiveness is in Jesus.
Right,
God's
not supposed to take the Bible
literally. You're not of your father.
And I definitely know a couple people who were in Christ but couldn't help it and ended up being homosexual. How do you know they are not going to go to heaven?
I know. Well, because you denounce the power of God. They have a form of God that's denying its power. The
power
of God changes nature.
The power of God is to forgive anybody. There is
no
sin greater than God.
God
forgives everything.
Wicked people. Because
if you go to God, no matter where you are in your life, He will forgive
you.
No matter what you do, exactly. No matter what you do, God forgives.
But you got to come to God in His church.
It doesn't mean
you change. If you don't repent, you aren't forgiven. If you don't repent, you're not forgiven. And that repentance means you turn from your own ways.
No, I still, okay. I'm going to go to hell right there.
What do you say?
They're living in rebellion towards God, and they're going to be destroyed.
Why so much propaganda? Why can't we just settle this peacefully and not angrily?
I'm not angry.
Would God put you in hell just so?
Well, your voice sounded angry.
I'm just
like the way you
making people angry.
I'm projecting my
Of course. Clearly, he had the perfect examples. People get angry.
It's because you guys hate God.
We don't hate God.
My God's the one true God. Your God's a God that you made up in your own mind. It's not the God of the Bible.
Okay? Now that's blasphemy. You cannot declare anybody else's God against themselves.
Yeah.
How do you know they have their God? They don't worship the same God as you.
Because I can tell.
All we're doing is having a debate. You can
tell. Jesus
can
tell them by
the fruits. Okay, what do I believe in? Tell me, do I believe in the same God that you do?
Well, we'll find out. Are you born again?
I'm definitely born again. I've been baptized. I've been on mission trips. How do I know? Because I believe that God came down. God sent His Son in perfect form. God, He lived a perfect life, sinless. He died on the cross for our sins, shedding His blood, okay, made it clean. He rose on the third day, defeating death, so that we can have a relationship with Christ.
That's
so
right.
Does that prove my
point?
So now you can believe those facts because the devil believes those facts too.
Yeah.
And all the demons. But they're not saved. They're going to go to hell. So a lot of people believe what he just came out of his mouth. But see, the evidence that you truly believe that, now you live a life of obedience to the word of God.
But
and
you know, no one can be obedient to the fullest potential that God wants us to be.
Who says?
What do you mean, who says? Have you ever read the Bible?
1 John chapter 3. It says, whoever's born of God does not practice habitual sin because God's seed remains in it.
Can
cannot sin because born of God.
Him?
What you want to do is justify your own sin. Out of the abundance of heart.
I'm not trying to
justify.
God justifies my
own
sin.
Oh, this guy's a...
Ooh.
Yeah.
If I
want
to do this, I'm not having a discussion with you.
Can you please get out?
And pretend that you follow Christ and live a life of disobedience to God. Because you can't serve two masters. See, sin is living independently from God, not surrender to the Lordship of Christ. A person that's saved follows and obeys Christ and loves it and wants to live a righteous
life. They love it, but no one lives a perfect
grace.
Life. So you can't live up to the expectations that God has given you.
In Christ.
And for that, your faith grows stronger because you have to rely on Him. So nobody can live that perfect life.
Yeah, Christ. In Christ, God sees the person that's born again in Christ is no longer a sinner or a criminal, but now a son or daughter of God. So there's a difference for those that are in Christ.
Oh, look, the police are here.
They're
not in Christ.
How do you? How do you not? How are you? Are you God on that judgment day? Do you know what judgment day comes that He is going to
homosexual? Certain fact. Is a homosexual and receives Jesus Christ. They're no longer going to get Jesus.
Because a neighbor
just came in.
She wants them out. But then what time do you, what do you count to serving the peace? Is this public strength that they can go on? I got it on my phone
if you really want to see the Bible. Yep, they cheated the law.
Thank you.
Can we just all believe in Zeus? No.